Welcome, everyone. On behalf of Annunciation Parish, I welcome everyone to our liturgy and extend a special welcome to all guests and visitors who are with us today. If you have not already done so, please silence or turn off all pagers and cell phones and other electronic devices. Today, we are celebrating the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is Father Celestine, assisted by Deacon Vic Bakeki. We have a few announcements. Please consider becoming a sponsor to adopt a family in one of our neighboring parishes by providing boxes of food for those in need on Thanksgiving. For more information, please see our bulletin. Our Lady of Annunciation is forming a venturing crew. Venturing is a program of the Boy Scouts of America for males and females ages 14 to 21. Interested youth and their parents are encouraged to attend an informational meeting on Wednesday, October the 28th at 6:30 in the Community Center. Bring your questions and do not forget your mask. Next weekend, we will take up our annual collection for the World Missions of the Catholic Church. Thank you for your generosity. If you would please rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and love of God, and coming of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Good evening. Good evening. We thank the Lord for giving us another beautiful day, and we thank him for inviting us to this Messianic banquet, the Eucharist of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we ask him to give us a sanctifying grace to enable us to participate well at this Messianic banquet. Let us take a moment and confess our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I've done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father.
God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. We make our prayer to our Lord Jesus Christ, our Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Goodness and
kindness follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To God our Father, to God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus again in reply spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burnt their cities. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out therefore into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find.' The servants went out into the street and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet the guests, he saw a man there not dressed in a wedding garment. The king said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet and cast him into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Many are invited, but few are chosen. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends in Christ, the first reading and the gospel present to us the ultimate worth every one of us as Christians, as believers in God, hope for, long for. That is the Messianic banquet, this wedding feast God invites us. God is the host. The greatest gift God has given to us is His knowledge, the knowledge of God. So if you have the knowledge of God, you have the greatest gift on earth, in the whole world, in heaven and on earth. That's the greatest gift. And the highest reward is seeing God face to face. That's the highest reward. You may get a lot of honors, Nobel Prize, award from men, from God, but the highest one is seeing God face to face. That's why the prophet Isaiah was very happy in his prophecy today. Say, behold our God, who we have been waiting for, who we were waiting to save us, and we are happy, we are glad that He has saved us, that God has saved us. I pray to be among those who will see God face to face. That's my prayer, that's my goal. And He will give us the best, the choicest wine. Remember, Christ said that I will not drink this wine again until the last day in the kingdom of God. He gives the best. We know how we prepare for feast. Many of us are experts, professionals in organizing feast. But this one is the one done by God. So it's going to be the best. And during that feast, He will destroy death, the worst enemy of creation, the worst enemy of man. He will wipe away every tear, every disappointment, every sorrow in our life. We long for justice, we long for equality, we long for equity. It is only God that will give us that. He's the one that has the power and the will. We as human beings, we have the will, but we don't have the power most of the time. So my dear friends in Christ, we should be one of the happiest people on earth with the readings of today, reminding us what God has prepared for us as baptized Christians and believers in Him. He calls for one thing in the first reading and also in the gospel. Remember the man that came in, but wasn't wearing the wedding garment. God invited everybody, like the host in the gospel, the good and the bad. But the only job is to take on the wedding garment, take on the sanctifying grace God has provided already. Wear the word of God, get the faith. That's the only thing that required of us. And it's not too difficult for us to do. But this young man ignored that. So that's why he was thrown out of the party. Let us not give excuses on that day. Remember those who were invited first, they gave excuses. One went to the farm, another one went for his business or her business. We have a lot of things that will make us not to be discouraged to honor God's invitation. There are a lot of things that will make us lose our faith. We say abuses in the church, corruption in the church, evil men in the church, people in court where they still claim they are Christians. There are a lot of things that can frustrate us. But let us remember the one who invites us. It is not those people that invited us. It is God that invited us. So if we have any complaint to make, we make it to God. But we know that He will take care of everything as He took care of everybody that we invited. So let us do our own part and allow God to do His own path. Then in the second reading, that reading, very special, and that letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, he called it the loveless letter, the epistle of joy. St. Paul was content, he was satisfied with his life, with himself. What is the secret? He said, I have learned the secret of living in hunger and living in abundance. I have learned the secret. And what is the secret? He doesn't plan for a project, then he invites God into the project. No. He goes into God's project and makes it his own. There are two things. We can make our plans and pray over it. It is different from asking for God's plan for us and follow God's plans. So that's what Christians do. We have no project different from God's project. We have no plans different from God's plan. So St. Paul was happy, he was content, because he made God's plan his plan. He made God's project his project. He made God's mission his own mission. Remember, he's the one that said in Galatians chapter 2, verse 20, I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I that lives. The life I live in the flesh, I live it in Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who loved me and died for me. So it's like taking away the heart of St. Paul, taking away the mind of St. Paul and put the mind of Christ, the heart of Christ. So it's no longer St. Paul living. So little wonder then, in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, he said, there's nothing I cannot master. There's nothing I cannot do by the strength of Christ, by the one who strengthens me. Who is the one strengthening him? Christ, who lived in him, who lives in him. So that is the secret. So if we want to be happy, if we want to be content, let us go for the assignment God has given to us. Let us get ourselves with the plan of God on earth. Ask God, what is your plan? I want to be part of your project. It is only there that we have our fulfillment. Remember, after Augustine has roamed and lived the life he wanted to live, St. Augustine said, Our souls are restless until they rest in you, God. God has made us for him, and our souls cannot rest unless we are part and parcel of God's life and will. So if you want to be contented with what you have, we have to change our perspective, see things from the eyes of God. We go and take the point of view of God, change our perspective, change our priorities, and then who is the source of our strength? Is it our position? They can't last. Is it our politics? They can't last. Is it demon? It can't last. Is it certain? It cannot. Is it his agent? No. We can only do all things by Christ who strengthens us. Remember, he tells us that apart from me, you can do nothing. John 15, verse 5. We cannot do anything. Then he ends today's episode by saying, thanking the Philippians for helping him out with money. They were generous to St. Paul, who was in prison. They took care of his needs. And St. Paul was very grateful to them. And he ended by saying, my God, the God I serve and I do his mission, will supply all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ. The question is not, can God supply all our needs? No, that's not the question. The question is, would God supply all our needs? Would he? He can, but would he? Yeah, he would, if we show true trust. If we package our trust 100% and give it to God, God, into your hands, I commit my spirit, my trust, my faith. Then after that, we obey him. Not according to my will, but let your will be done. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. My brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, in the life of the world to come. Amen. We trust in God's mercy and abundant love. Let us make our request known to him.
for our church. May God continue to help us grow in holiness and strength as we nurture a culture of healing and life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For lawmakers, may God's grace direct their hearts in proposing laws that protect the life and rights of all people, including those yet to be born. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are sick, may they know the healing power of Christ, who is our divine physician. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us here, may the Lord continue to help us speak the truth in charity to one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who've died from this faith community and from our families, may they find a place at the banquet of life in the eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for all of those special needs and intentions that remain silently in our hearts, for all of this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty and eternal God, our salvation comes from you alone. As we rush over the lives of our people, hear the prayers we offer this day and answer them according to your holy will. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become for us our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite hearts, may be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the Holy Cross, he freed us from our ending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the bread and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which I'm giving up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which he poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we'll be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John West, Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
And the Savior's command formed by divine teaching without a prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we'll be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as our well blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles and to all of us this evening, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with her will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Lord, I am not worthy that you should under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life. The rich suffer want and go hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no blessing. Let us pray. We entreat you, your majesty, most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ, glorifying the Lord with your lives. Thanks be to God. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
My shepherd will supply my need, the God of love supreme. In pastures green, you make me feed beside the is my stay.
drives all my fears away. You bend in sight of all my foes, dare still my table spread, my cup with blessings overflows. Your oil anoints my head. The sure provisions of my God attend me all my days.
Body of Christ.
Oh, may your house be my abode, and all my work be praise. There would I find a settled rest, while others go and come. No stranger nor a guest, but like a child at home.
The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Amen.
The living God, my shepherd is, I know no care or need. You guide me where rich pastures grow. Along the verdant mead, where every day by pleasant way my hungering soul may feed. You lead me where cool waters flow by rippling stream and rill, where I may taste the springs of life my thirsting spirit fill. You near me bide and homeward guide my vagrant heart and will. I nothing fear, for you, O Lord, are with me night and day. In tent with shepherd's staff and rod to guide me where I stray, and in the fold you will uphold my fainting heart.